Thank you for tuning in with TK On Demand. I'm Taylor Knight. The spread of COVID-19 has restricted a lot of family members and loved ones from seeing each other due to the fear of getting each other sick and with the travel restriction. Today we'll be talking to Marissa and Ricky, a couple in the Army who is dealing with an extended quarantine long-distance relationship, not seeing each other for over 5 months now due to the Army's travel restriction ban they have going on. We're going to talk to them, hear their story, and hear how they're coping with this and how they're keeping the magic alive in this extended long-distance relationship.
The love story begins in Tallahassee, Florida, where the two were in multiple social groups but never actually spoke.
We were also in RTC together in different organizations, but you know, Tallahassee, FSU, and FAMU are right next to each other. Like, we never actually really ever said anything to each other.
When they both graduated, Marissa heard that someone in the ROTC program was being sent to the same location as her in the Army.
So I followed them on Instagram and I found out that we were branching the same thing, which means we were going to be doing the same job in the Army. By a stroke of fate, we're going at the exact same time.
When Marissa arrived to the base, Ricky's first impression was,
like, she's too good for me, literally is what I thought.
But he mustered up the courage to go and introduce himself to Marissa in person for the first time.
It was very comfortable, like, I don't know, we kind of just kicked it off.
That's where the friendship started to grow into something more.
We would do these things where literally we would find out, hey, we don't have class the next day. And we'd be like, man, like, let's pull out the Uno card.
He's like, oh, we should each write our own rules on Uno cards. And I'm like, okay, bet.
Ricky decided to make his rule one kiss. After three rounds, he finally got to play the card.
You know, it's funny, that card took forever.
They decided to start dating, only for 3 months in person, before they began the long distance from Texas and Hawaii.
That equates to like 7 months of being together in person before going completely long distance. And we've been long distance more than we've been together since our relationship has lasted so long. So
what did you guys do to be in Hawaii versus Texas, which is like even further?
Yeah, it's like 13 hours.
I think to look at it as, so there's multiple parts, I think, when you look at long distance relationships. And I think a big part that plays a role is, what is your goals in the end, you know? We always knew that we were gonna get split up.
Knew from the jump that we were going to be far away from each other. So it was like,
to figure out, should I make that jump or should I just
let it die? Like, let this be a good time. And hey, if we meet up again, then we do.
Any other guy that I met in the military, it would be the same thing. Like, long distance until you're married, basically. Because the Army doesn't recognize boyfriend, girlfriend. Unless you're married, like, they don't care about putting people together. We always plan our next trip so that we have something to look forward to. On top of that, we also always plan, like, fun trips. So, like, we went to Vegas, we've been to Portland. He came to Hawaii, which in itself is, like, a vacation.
When COVID-19 happened and they put a travel restriction on the Army, how did you guys take that, knowing that you guys look forward to those trips? You guys look forward to those, okay, I can't wait to see him, I can't wait to see her. And now it's, like, it's shut down for who knows when.
It was a big hit.
Marissa and Ricky decide on their meetups whenever there is a federal holiday, giving them 4 days with each other.
Memorial Day, that was supposed to be our next meetup, because every 4 day, whenever the weekend, the Army has like a Thursday or a Friday and a Monday off, we always see each other. Mm-hmm. So that first one got canceled because of the travel ban. So we're like, dang, well, you know, once it's lifted, we'll just meet up on the next 4 days. Then the Army was like, no, we're going to push this travel ban out to like end of July. Yeah, it was pretty tough because I think long distance isn't as bad if you can consistently like stay in touch and see each other.
Marissa graduated with her MBA this past semester, and Ricky wanted to make sure she knew how proud he was.
For her to work and get her master's, you know, I was like, man, I really got to make this kind of special.
But I've never really been caught off guard like I did with the surprise. It was just so random. Usually I have like an inkling of an idea when like something's about to happen, like if it's the birthday coming up, but this was completely like out of left field.
Finagled it literally in like 2 weeks. And
impressive. 2 weeks to get all that in a whole other state that's an island far away. Wow.
It was just so thoughtful. I could not believe that this was like my real life, you know? That was unexpected. Like, when I posted it on Twitter, it was definitely the highlight, all his efforts, because that deserves to be highlighted for sure. Yeah.
What else do you guys do during quarantine to keep the long distance, like, alive?
Well, we sit for hours and we play video games together.
We did do a cooking thing where we both made cheesecake together.
So, do you guys have any advice for couples who are in your situation in the Army and are doing this extended long distance right now? What advice do you have to give them, or just any couple who's doing long distance?
So you lose the idea of being able to physically touch somebody. You lose the sense of, you know, like just being with that person all the time, to actually appreciating your conversations with that person and spending the little times that you guys do have. So, and it's up to you guys, because it's how much work you guys are willing to put in together.
Like, being long distance for majority of our relationship has really kind of made our connection so much stronger, because it forces us to communicate. It forces us to express how we feel, because not being next to someone, you can't really use your body language to, you know, communicate. It has to be all vocal. So now we know that our relationship can stand the test of distance, the test of time.
As they say, absence makes the heart fonder. And no matter how far apart Marissa and Ricky are, you can see their love they have for each other. All right, that's me, Taylor Knight, signing out with TK On Demand.